Hello, welcome to BarCloud. In this video, we'll discuss the chronological steps you must take to track your inventory. In general, you will need to follow three major steps: create your ecosystem, conduct transactions, and view your current and historical data. After you buy or subscribe to a system, the software vendor will then most likely give you a generic username and password to give you the initial access. Once you're in, the first step is to create your own user credential, but you need to make sure to grant yourself administrative security access in order to do all this. If you choose to opt for a system like BarCloud, we will give you full control to create and configure different security levels for yourself and all your users. Do follow this link to learn more about security settings. Next, you need to pre-create your locations and part numbers. It is best for you to decide how granular you want your tracking to get. In other words, would you want to set up your locations to be a general area, like having a part number in one specific room? Or would you rather know if this part number is located in an aisle, on a shelf, or in a specific bin? The same question is asked for your part numbers. Would you want to track your inventory in a more simple way by an inventory number and description? Or would you rather dive deeper into specifics like cost types such as FIFO, LIFO? Would you rather set up your minimums and maximums and dive even deeper into inventory types such as standard inventory, serialized inventory, and batched inventory? Follow this link to learn more about inventory types. Also, please take a second or two to like our video and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. I would also personally recommend you preset your categories, units of measure, consumers, departments, and vendors. Once all this is completed, you are now ready to conduct transactions such as receive, move, consume, pick, return, dispose, assemble, disassemble, pack, ship, and so much more, depending on the complexity and how modular the system you purchased is. Shortly after you start using the system, it is best to configure all your reporting screens. Dashboard to get a general visual illustrations of the things that are important to you. Grid views with filters, summaries, graphs that are relevant to your job function, and finally, classic reports. Systems often come with pre-made reports, but such reports are usually not enough and are too general. Hopefully, the system you decide to purchase allows you and each one of your users the ability to create all three types of reports individually, since not all users share the same reporting needs. And with that, you've learned all the basic steps to start tracking inventory to the best of your ability. For more information on the inventory management and asset tracking industry, like our video and subscribe to our channel now, or visit our website to learn more about our own inventory system and asset tracking solutions.